Hey guys, what's up? Awesome Dom here again with another video. Today, third day in a row to make a video. Well, second day in a row to make a video. Third day in 2 days. Third video, whatever. But I'm quarantined right now. Our school's closed. And so, I thought I'm just gonna make more YouTube videos. Currently, my editor has no internet. So I have a gaming video coming, but my editor has no internet. I feel really bad for him because, you know, he's a gamer, right? And because he's a gamer, he's not being able to game because his internet's down. And we're out of school for 3 weeks, so he doesn't have Google Classroom or anything like that. But anyways, I was thinking, like, I want to make a video, but I don't know what. But I want to stick to, like, this reacting stuff, because I like to react to, I've been liking reacting to these videos. First off, it's good content, because funny, whatever, but, yeah, and so I was thinking, like, what should I do? I'm like, aha, My Story Animated, what's smarter than that? Because we all know that all the classic commentary people watch this stuff, right? So I'll switch it over, right? Oh, we're here, My Story Animated. Oh boy, I cannot wait. I just can't. I can't simply wait to watch my sister is dating the whole entire town.
I've been swiping on Tinder for weeks and haven't
it's the
even
Joker.
Had one match.
Wait, hold on. Go back there. Go back there.
I've been swiping on Tinder for weeks.
It's the Joker. You know, the guy that says we live in a society. It's him.
And hadn't even had one match. I didn't get
Dang.
It. It's not like I was butt ugly or anything. Finally, my phone beeped. I'd matched with someone. He asked
what?
Me to meet in an hour at a nearby cafe, and so I quickly changed into
This surely won't end in a bad way or anything. This clearly won't be a kidnapping situation.
Cute outfit and rushed out the door. When I saw him, I was shocked.
Female, hot.
Sitting in a booth with a girl opposite him. I couldn't believe it. I'd heard this kind of thing could happen, where a guy would have two dates in a row. I decided to walk by and see if he noticed me. Well, he did, and he legit screamed, and in the process, knocked his soda all over his date. Ha, served them both right. But then he stood up and started pointing at me and said, "There's two of you." The girl
what?
Turned
What? There's two
around,
of them?
I didn't know whether to laugh or cry. It was my sister, my identical twin sister to be precise.
That dirty little goblin.
Bell,
how dare she
what are you
steal his
at?
Date?
I said. She got annoyed at me and said I'd ruined her new dress by turning up like that and giving her date a fright. She said she'd come in for a coffee and this guy had run up to her and started chatting. I told her I'd matched with him on Tinder and that he was waiting for me. The whole time, the guy just stood there, looking back and forth between us. We must have been making a lot of noise because suddenly some other random guy came up to us and in a not so subtle way told the guy that I was supposed to be on a date with that me and my sister had been with everyone in town and that he should run while he still had the chance. Excuse me, I said. This was supposed to be my first date ever. Like the first date I've ever been on in my life.
Bro.
But the random guy just burst out laughing and said, "Sure, and I'm the Queen of England." Then he walked off, and my date left with him. As they walked out the door, I heard the waiter say, "Sorry, bud. Those girls are always up to no good." That was the final straw.
What?
I'd had it with my sister. My whole life, she'd always gotten her way. The only reason she even graduated...
I like how she's breathing fire, you know, like... die.
...in high school was because she made me
this
sit
is,
her exams.
This is insane.
I felt like such an idiot. No wonder I'd only had one match on Tinder. Oh. Everyone probably assumed I was my sister and wanted to run for the hills. I mean, I knew my sister was pretty active in the dating scene, but I didn't know she was basically hooking up with every guy she set her eyes upon. I stormed out of the cafe and she ran after me. She said it was just coincidence what had happened in the
no.
cafe.
Mm-mm,
and that she hadn't
no.
dated that many guys, but I didn't believe her. She'd always been like this. She used to steal my toys, then my friends, and now my first date ever. I was 21, and all
dang,
I wanted was to meet
dang. Her sister's savage.
Nice guy and marry him. How hard could it be?
What the?
I tried Tinder
okay,
a few
then.
More times, but one guy messaged me
Joker.
Saying I was a liar. That my name wasn't Cassie, it was Belle, and that if I thought I could fool him, I had another thing coming. Then he blocked
threat.
Me. I'd been away at college for 3 years, and I'd been so focused on...
That was a threat. I mean, like, come on, man. Threat?
My studies. I hadn't made any time for guys. Now I was back home, and my sister had messed everything up. But I wasn't going to give up that easily. The next time I saw her heading out for a date, I followed her. I wanted to see what she did that made guys so weary of her.
Yes.
Did she just go on one date, then dump them? Also, I kind of wanted to get back at her for what she'd done to me. I kept a safe distance and watched as she met this guy in the park. They chatted for a bit, then they went off together. I tried to follow, but I lost sight of them. An old woman noticed me and said, "Oh dear, I think I'm seeing double." Then she wandered off. Damn, I couldn't believe I'd lost them.
No.
I waited for ages, and eventually they came back. And my sister kissed him goodbye and went off to her car. For some reason, he stayed in the park. And after 20 minutes, I decided I had nothing to lose. I walked up to him, and he started grinning. "Back for more already?" he said. I have no idea why, but I told him that, yes, I missed him already, and maybe we could hang out some more. He looked at my outfit and frowned. Then I said I'd quickly change because I was feeling cold, and then he shrugged his shoulders and said I looked even cuter now. The awkward part was that I didn't even know his name, but I couldn't exactly ask him now. We ended up chatting for hours, and I apologized for making a move so quickly. And he said it had been fun, but maybe we should slow down and get to know each other properly first. I agreed. And then when he went to the bathroom, I took his phone and quickly changed my sister's number in his phone to my number. At least I knew his name now. Kenneth. We said goodbye and I went home and waited until my sister was asleep. Then I took her phone and deleted his number and blocked him on her Tinder. I just had hoped that she didn't notice. The next morning, I asked about her date the day before. She said he wasn't her type and that she wouldn't see him again. Thank God, I thought. But there was just one small problem. I really liked him. But he thought I was my sister. I had to ask Belle what she talked about with him so I didn't mess up the next time I saw him. But she just winked at me and said, "We didn't really do much talking, if you know what I mean." I texted him straight away and said I'd really enjoyed yesterday and couldn't wait to see him again.
I don't like that. I don't like that. I don't know why this is on YouTube. I don't know why this is on YouTube. This is all just a bunch of lies. Lies, man. That's all it is just lies.
Wow. Someone actually wanted to go on a date with me. I mean, okay, he thought I was Belle, but so what? It was me he actually liked, right? That night, we went to the movies, and I told my sister I was going to my friend's house. She just teased me if she knew I had a date. And of course, she had another date already.
Of course she did.
At the movies, we waited in line to buy popcorn, and when we got to the front, the girl said, "One box not enough?" I was confused. Then I realized what was going on. This couldn't be happening. I told Kenneth I wasn't feeling well, and he said he was sure I'd feel better after taking a seat. Ugh, I just wanted to get out of there. What were the chances that both me and Belle were on dates at exactly the same movie theater? He went to the bathroom, and I stood there waiting nervously. Then I felt a hand on my back and heard a voice saying, "Ready, babe? Movie starts in 5. But it wasn't Kenneth's voice. No.
I told him
to use the toilet quickly, but he was like, "Didn't you just go?" So I laughed and said, "Yep. Tiny bladder. Meet you in the back row." Then I ran into the toilets. I knew my sister was in there, and I just had to hope she didn't see me. Luckily, she was still in the cubicle, but she was on the phone and already arranging her next date. She was insane. Still on one date and already planning the next one.
I can't believe this person.
I couldn't risk her going out and bumping it to Kenneth. So I went back out, and luckily, the coast was clear. Her date was gone, and it was just Kenneth standing there. I told him I'd been puking and really needed to go home, so we left. He seemed disappointed, but said we could just go see the movie another time. I decided the only way to date Kenneth was to do it in secret from now on. I knew I'd have to come clean at some point, but I wasn't ready for that yet. He kept asking to meet my
friend. That was a close one, guys. That was a close one in this epic, epic journey.
But I always said they were too busy, and eventually he stopped asking. We always hung out at his place.
Why does he look like a creep? He's like...
which suited me fine. After a few months, my sister announced that she was taking a trip to visit a friend on the West Coast. She just up and left, which I found totally weird.
Goodbye.
I'd been spending a lot of time with Kenneth, so I hadn't been home much. But our mom said she was acting kind of quiet, and she thought something might be wrong. Meanwhile, Kenneth still called me Belle. It was starting to bug me. This whole time, I'd always thought I was nicer than my sister, but in reality, I was just as bad as her. I tried calling her, and every time she answered, she said she was fine. But I had a feeling something was up. Maybe she knew I was dating Kenneth and had left because she felt hurt. But then she finally told me the real reason she left. She said she was pregnant and she was trying to figure out who the dad was. My heart almost stopped. Then she said she was 99% sure it was this guy who lived on the West Coast, so she'd gone there to find him, and he was super happy, and now they were thinking about getting married. I couldn't believe it. I never thought my sister was the kind of person to get married. This whole time, my goal had been to find a nice guy to marry, and she'd beat me to it. After we hung up the phone, I decided to tell her that I was dating someone. I called her back, and she said she was so happy for me and couldn't wait to meet him. I chickened out from telling her his name, though, but she'd find out eventually. That night, I was going to Kenneth's for dinner with his parents. He picked me up, and as soon as I got in the car, I knew something was wrong. He looked angry, and he took out his phone and showed me a picture. It was my sister and her boyfriend at Disneyland in LA. He said his cousin had just sent him this pic, and did I want to explain myself? The picture had been taken the weekend before when I'd canceled my date with Kenneth because I hadn't been feeling well, but now he didn't believe me. He thought I was cheating on him. Oh no, I had to tell him. Actually, that's my twin sister, I said. And he looked at me like I was insane and told me to get out of his car. But I begged him to listen to me. I told him that she was actually Belle and I was Cassie, and that I pretended to be her the first day in the park because I was getting revenge on her, that I'd actually fallen for him. And by then it felt too late to admit what I'd done. Then I told him my sister had moved to LA to live with her fiancé. I even showed him a photo of me and Belle together so he'd believe me. He told me to get out of his car, and he said he never wanted to see me again. I was devastated. I'd completely messed up. Kenneth stopped replying to my messages, and I found it hard to go to work and act like a normal person.
I feel that feeling too.
My sister too, even if she had kind of driven me to do this in the first place. After a few months, she came home. Her bump was huge.
Bro.
She was only 8 weeks away from popping.
What?
But she was alone, and I knew that meant her and her fiancé had broken up. She said he knew he couldn't be the father because the dates didn't match up. So he told her to go home, and now she was going to be a single
mom. It's going
to
be Kenneth. Let's be honest. The father's going to be Kenneth.
She said, oh man, all guys are the same. But I was lying. You see, I'd started seeing Kenneth
again. It's going to be Kenneth.
He said he missed me so much too, and that life felt empty without me in it. So we'd been meeting up in secret. At the same time, my sister and I started to grow even closer, and when she gave birth, I was right there with her. I told her to do a paternity test to figure out who the dad was, but she said she didn't care. She could manage it alone. When my nephew was born, though, I knew something was up. He had thick red hair, and that could only mean one thing.
I told you.
And when she saw him for the first time, she knew it too. I know who the dad is, she said. Oh. And I wanted to scream because I knew exactly who the dad was too, and that meant my life was over. Kenneth had red hair. I decided there was only one thing for it. An hour later, Kenneth turned up at the hospital. I texted him and told him to come quickly, and he was so worried. He thought something was wrong with me. When he arrived and saw me standing there next to Belle and her newborn baby, he almost passed out. I felt so stupid. How had I not thought of this before?
No.
My sister asked Kenneth how he knew to find me, and then before I could even say anything, he blurted out that he'd been dating me for the past 9 months. And my sister looked at me with so much hurt in her eyes. What should have been the happiest moment of her life had just turned into a complete disaster.
You dirty poop.
You're probably assuming that my sister and Kenneth got back together to raise their son, right?
Yes.
Well, not exactly. You see, Kenneth and I were seriously in love. He wanted to marry me. And although it's weird to marry the man who got your sister pregnant, these things happen.
Yeah, you look the same. It doesn't matter.
But I know we'll have a lot of explaining to do in the future. Their son is going to wonder why his dad is also his uncle. Whenever Kenneth and I take him out to play, people just assume he's my baby. We're getting married soon.
Oh,
and who knows?
Yeah.
Maybe we'll have a baby not long after. His cousin will also be his half-brother. Yep, it's kind of complicated.
Oh, I didn't think of that. Well, that was fun. See you guys later. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Probably another video coming later today. I might play Warzone. Giggity, giggity, bruh.